comes to me, not necessarily like where I'm gonna be, but my thoughts, my feelings, the things I'm going through. No, I don't actually stress out about putting those online, even though, yes, I have gotten negative feedback before about my life. Good morning, everybody. It is April 8th. It is day 8 of Plan As You Go, where I show how I use my bullet journal, my Erin Condren horizontal, and my power sheets together in tandem for an entire month. I actually did not really touch my bullet journal yesterday. I was just exhausted by the time I got to my planners in the afternoon from giving the sermon, which went well, but yeah. So I am going to get that set up for the week today, as well as all the other things. Let's start with my power sheets. As you guys can see so far, only two of my daily habits have been going well. Today, I need to get this wrapped up because tomorrow the book club actually starts. If you haven't signed up for that yet, you can find all the information in the description box. We are reading Heart Talk by Cleo Wade. Everything kicks off tomorrow. Now, I know this week I got to do the receipts and some other stuff to get ready for taxes, but today, looking at all of this, I feel like if I get this email work finished today and I finish my planning out my new content today, then I will have, and we're going to do family planning tonight. So those will be all things that we can take care of today. So I'm going to set this to the side and get my Erin Condren set up for the rest of today. Okay, so looking at this, looking at what we've already got going on today, a patron post goes live. I have an interview with somebody at 9. I will let you guys know where you can find that as soon as I have the information. I am doing family planning tonight. I have to send the notes from our meeting yesterday. Other than that, I need to spend some time today working on the launch for tomorrow and doing some more planning for the rest of the month, basically. All right, so I used some stickers from Chrissy Ann Designs for the laundry Jesse and I need to do today. And this one's Marth Love laptop munchkin, which I need to order more of. I probably should put that on my list for today too, because there's a couple of different munchkins I need to order before finishing up the launch for tomorrow for book club. So that is all of today figured out. I really love the colors this week, I'm just saying. I'm gonna set this to the side. Like I said, I did not touch my bullet journal yesterday damn near at all. So I need to get my pain tracker updated for 2 days, and both of them were double painkiller days. It's been a really hard weekend for me in terms of pain. You can probably hear it in my voice that I'm still kind of feeling the painkiller. It's been really bad. I think I may have burst a cyst, which sounds gross, but is a reality when you have polycystic kidney disease. I don't know for sure though. There's some other signs I haven't seen yet, but it's just been bad. So what I'm gonna actually do, because I very, very rarely take more than one painkiller per day, not counting the time that I was recovering from surgery. That wasn't out of like any sort of the ordinary because it was an extreme circumstance. But taking, for kidney pain, taking a painkiller twice in one day is something that is really different for me. So I'm gonna do something. I'm gonna mark it on here. Oh, hi, Mark. I just put two on top of those so that it would be a reminder that those 2 days I actually took two painkillers. Moving forward to April, I have two doodles I need to do. I'm also gonna have, I have two more questions to answer from that one video with all the questions, and today I will open it back up. The first doodle is for today and or for yesterday, and it is Sandy Cheeks. I think the double outline served to make Sandy kind of look like a raccoon. Whoops. Oh well. The other doodle for today is Mrs. Puff. I think that one turned out a little bit better than Sandy, which is too bad because Sandy's one of my favorites. Going to this last week to see what I actually finished. I did almost everything except for start my taxes. I did write my sermon because I gave it already. And I did everything on this list except for the inbox. I'm going to do my lettering for today, for yesterday. Then we'll get this week set up and I will start answering questions now. One of them is from Tamara, who said, I'm interested in learning more about UU Church from listening to you talk about it in your videos. What key info or advice would you give to someone looking into UU as a possible community? I was raised Catholic loosely, but consider myself agnostic. I miss the sense of community that comes from belonging to such a group of people, and it sounds like it might be a good fit for me. I kind of skimmed over some of that there. Before I answer, today is, well, this is Donkey Dunk Cucumber, so that's a lot to fit in here. I only noticed like this when my patrons pointed it out a couple days ago. I wrote Bob at Work instead of Bob at Worm. Whoops, it's been a long week. My biggest advice to you is to just check it out and to remember that all UU fellowships and churches are different. Depending on the minister, depending on the congregation, there'll be a different focus at each one. I know there's some churches that all kind of have like something specific they're supposed to talk about each week, like it's kind of uniform between churches, but with UU churches, it's very different depending on who the minister is and who the people in the congregation are. My church tends to lean a little bit more humanist/pagan, but I know of others that tend to lean more Christian. So you just have to check it out to find out. Yeah, I mean, that's my biggest advice to you. And to go in, and to also my other advice would be to give it a few Sundays before you decide whether it's for you or not, because just like each congregation is different, each Sunday often is quite different. So you want to give it a few tries to really see if the community aspect and the church, like what they talk about, is something that you're super interested in. And I will also say that at least in my congregation, the biggest sense of community you will get is either after the church service at the coffee hour or during committee meetings, which is in and of itself a little intense because you're signing up to spend some time. But like, I first started getting to know people at my UU congregation when I joined the choir, when I joined the social justice committee, and when I joined the religious education committee. So that is a good place to start making friends in kind of a smaller setting rather than all of the people that attend a congregation. So I hope that answered your question. All right, I'm going to get the new week set up. The second question is actually more about YouTube and being a YouTuber. So this is interesting. It's from Grateful Heart, who asked, do you ever worry about having your life, even a small part of it, on YouTube? I've considered starting a channel, but I am such a private person. I don't know if I'd be comfortable putting myself out there for negative feedback and negative people. Any advice? I've said this for several of these questions. This could be a podcast episode or maybe another YouTube video. And who knows, maybe it will be. But I will also address this here. Yes, I do worry sometimes. That's why I don't show as much of my kids as I should show. I actually respect their privacy and their time. There's a lot about my kids I don't talk about. And if you see them in a vlog or if they pop up on my channel, it's because they chose to, not because I tried to get them on here, specifically because I'm aware, especially as teenagers, especially in this digital time where they are online a lot, that their friends are online a lot, the last thing I want to do is put them in a situation where they are getting their lives put on camera without their consent. So, I mean, I've always felt that way about them. I'm very aware of it now, so I don't put that out there. I mean, I do put my plans out there, and that in and of itself can be a scary thing. You know, I've had to consider, like, is it a good idea to put when we're going out of town in my planner? Is it a good idea to put that out there before I go out of town? It's something I've been thinking about, you know? But in general, it doesn't bother me too much in terms of putting out my like the things, like when it comes to me, not necessarily like where I'm gonna be, but my thoughts, my feelings, the things I'm going through. No, I don't actually stress out about putting those online, even though, yes, I have gotten negative feedback before about my life, and I've gotten it, and I'll continue to get it. That's one of the kind of guarantees of putting yourself out there online, is that you will get negative feedback regardless of how quote unquote perfect your life might look. Today's slippery dick. It's really easy, and it's something they tell us, they, whoever they are, when you're online, to ignore the haters, focus on the good, because it's really easy to focus on the one negative comment when you get a whole bunch of good comments. It's easy to say that, but in practice, it's not easy because it hurts. If you're somebody who's sensitive, or you're somebody who really cannot do well with negative feedback, especially negative feedback that's not in a constructive sense, it may not be something you want to explore because it's going to happen. You have to just learn to cope with it. I have a healthy dose of fuck the haters kind of in my system. You know, if somebody leaves a comment, I'm just like, whatever. It still gets to me, but I've gotten to a point where I'm able to kind of allow it to get to me for a hot minute and then shake it off. I have developed that, but I've been making videos for a long time now, and it wasn't always like that. So my advice for you would be, if you want to start a YouTube channel, start putting yourself out there, my advice is kind of two parts. The first part is, know in advance somebody is going to say something mean or hateful or rude or even constructive criticism that you weren't necessarily looking for, which is not a bad thing, but it can also hurt. Know that hurtful things are going to come when people find you. It will happen. And know that you can't do anything about that, and you don't need to change who you are or what you do for somebody else. So just know that. Be prepared for it. So when it does happen, it's not a surprise. And also know that the chances are you will be having a lot more people who are excited to see you than there are people who suck ass. So be prepared for that too. Secondly, if you're going to be putting yourself out there, but you know that there are certain areas of your life that maybe you are not ready to hear feedback on, or you want to keep private, set boundaries. I remember talking to Sam from Happily a Housewife on my podcast, and she had set very specific boundaries for herself and her channel of things she would talk about and things she wouldn't talk about. And she said that that's helped her as she's made videos for years and years. Knowing that these things are off limits has kept her from kind of going down that path. So if you set, like, think about your life, set some hard boundaries for what you don't want to put out there, what you're not prepared to hear comments about, or what you just don't want to share with everybody, that will help you when you're making videos. And it'll help negate some of the negative feedback because it won't be about these specific things that are really upsetting you. Secondly, when it comes to boundaries, remember that you yourself, you, nobody else has the right to set them, and you can set them whenever you want to. So if you start making content and you say, okay, these are my boundaries and this is okay for me to talk about, and then you realize maybe it's not okay for you to talk about, fucking set a new boundary. And if people give you shit, not their fucking life. Anyway, I've gotten to a little bit of a tirade, but I hope that that helped you. I'm gonna get my to-do list for this week. This was my Saturday shit list. It was just my way of coping with a day where I was stressed out as fuck. All right, there's my list for today. I'm kind of squishing it in here, but it's working. With this talk of boundaries, I would love to know from you in the comments, what are some boundaries you have set in your life, whether because you put stuff out there on the internet or just in general, like boundaries with other people, boundaries with your family, boundaries with yourself. One of the boundaries in my life that I have set and have been pretty good about is respecting my kids' privacy when it comes to my YouTube channel. I only allow them on here when they choose to, and I don't talk about all the things going on in their life unless they let me. That's something I feel very proud of myself for. I'm not great at setting boundaries for myself personally when it comes to things like saying no. I'm working on it, but I'm not great at it. So I would love to hear your experience with setting boundaries in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you in tomorrow's Plan As You Go video.